Good morning, folks. I like to do another subject about the Bible and what is happening in Europe. I tried to make another movie, but it failed, so I do it again on my mobile phone. Maybe not the best resolution, but okay. Here it goes. It's again, Deuteronomy 28. From starting from verse 15, and I'll read out the whole passage to you. Deuteronomy 28 is about the blessing and the curse. The blessings if you listen to God, the curses if you don't listen to God. And the majority of Europe is not listening to God right now. Europe was listening to God in the Middle Ages, and Europe flourished. Europe was blessed, and so on and so on. Today, terms have been twisted around. People don't listen to God, prefer not to listen to God, and the curses will come along with it. And I will read out the curses, these curses that are striking Europe right now as we speak. Unfortunately, because God does not want you to be cursed, He wants you to be blessed. But okay, if you don't believe me, I will. Or if you don't believe God, let me put it that way. It's not about me, it's about God. Okay. However, if you do not obey the Lord your God and do not carefully follow all His commandments and decrees that I'm giving you today, all these curses will come upon you and overtake you. You will be cursed in the city and cursed in the country. Your basket and your kneading trough will be cursed. The fruit of your womb will be cursed, and the crops of your land, and the calves of your herds, and the lambs of your flocks. You will be cursed when you come in, and you will be cursed when you go out. The Lord will send on you curses, confusion, and rebuke in everything you put your hand to, until you are destroyed and come to sudden ruin because of the evil you have done in forsaking Him. So Europe is forsaking God, the majority is at least. And Europe used to be a Christian continent, and this continent is forsaking God. So this is what you get. The Lord will plague you with diseases until He has destroyed you from the land you are entering to possess. The Lord will strike you with a wasting disease, with fever and inflammation, with scorching heat and drought, with blight and mildew. Scorching heat, California rings a bell. Which will plague you until you are perished. The sky over your head will be bronze. God will not listen to your prayers if you do not repent on time. That's what it means. The ground beneath you will be iron. The Lord will turn the rain of your country into dust and powder. Icelandic volcanic ashes, remember it, anybody rings a bell? It will come down from the skies until you are destroyed. The Lord will cause you to be defeated before your enemies. You will come at them from one direction, but flee from them in seven. And you will come become a thing of horror to all the kingdoms on earth. Your carcasses will be food for all the birds of the air and beasts of the earth, and there will be no one to frighten them away. The Lord will afflict you with the boils of Egypt, and with the tumors, festering sores, and the itch from which you cannot be cured. The Lord will afflict you with madness, blindness, and confusion of mind. At midday you will grope about like a blind man in the dark. You will be unsuccessful in everything you do. Day after day you will be oppressed and robbed. Colon rings a bell, maybe. France, Paris, stuff like that. And with no one to rescue you. You will be pledged to marry a woman, but another will take her and ravish her. You will build a house, but you will not live in it. You will plant a vineyard, but you will not even begin to enjoy its fruit. Your ox will be slaughtered before your eyes, but you will eat none of it. Your donkey will be forcibly taken from you and will not be returned. Your sheep will be given to your enemy and no one will rescue them. Your sons and daughters will be given to another nation, and you will wear out your eyes watching for them day after day, powerless to lift a hand. The people that you do not know will eat your land and labor produce, and you will have nothing but cruel oppression all your days. The sight you will see drive you mad. The Lord will afflict your knees and legs with painful boils. sorry, folks. A painful boils that cannot be cured. Spreading from the sole of your feet to the top of your head, the Lord will drive you and the king you set over you to a nation unknown to you or your fathers. There you will worship other gods, gods of wood and stone. You will become a thing of horror and an object of scorn and ridicule to all the nations where the Lord will drive you. You will sow much seed in the fields, but you will harvest little, because locusts will devour it. You will plant vineyards and cultivate them, but will not drink the wine or gather the grapes, because worms will eat them. You will have olive trees throughout your country, but you will not use the oil, because the olives will drop off. Well, we have a lot of troubles with our honeybees. The bees are here to fertilize or pollinate the trees and plants and so on to grow crops. But it's getting more and more a problem. Last summer there was a pest of some kind of animal, a worm, taking the hedges of all the people here in the south of Holland. These things are getting more and more regular. You will have sons and daughters, but you will not keep them, because they will go into captivity. The thing is, there are many interracial marriages here, and in some cases, these do not have end happily, because the children were taken away and taken to the country of to the other country of the country of one of the. In this case, mostly the man's original country. It happened in Holland, folks. It's reality. It happened. And it's happening that the children are forced to stay with the father in another country. It happened here in Holland, at least, several times already. Swarms of locusts will take over all your trees and the crops of your land. Like I said, that's happening already. The alien who lives among you will rise above you higher and higher, but you will sink lower and lower. That's basically happening what's in Europe happening. Charlie Hebdo, right away now, Köln, in Paris, France, last year, and also in the beginning of this year. Folks, it's getting more and more. He will lend to you, but you will not lend to him. He will be the head, but you will be the tail. All these curses will come upon you. They will pursue you and overtake you until you are destroyed, because you did not obey the Lord your God and observe the commandments and decrees he gave you. They will be a sign and a wonder to you and your descendants forever, because you did not observe the Lord your God joyfully and gladly in a time of prosperity. In time of prosperity, like I said, in the Middle Ages, everybody believed in God. Everybody took the Bible as true, or at least 95 to 99% of the population. And Europe prospered. It was the most powerful continent on Earth, as we know today. I mean, they conquered a lot of countries and became prosperous, rich, based on that. Today, we see the reversed process going on. People say no to God. They say, well, it's a science. We believe in science. What do you need with God? And the reverse process is all these curses are taking place right as we speak. But it's not too late yet, I think. At least not at the moment that I'm giving out this movie. There's still room for repentance. God does not want you to be cursed. He wants you to be blessed. But that means that you need to listen to God and what he says in God's word, the Bible, via Jesus Christ, Yeshua HaMashiach. That's my advice to you, and also God's advice to us, of course. I will go on. Therefore, in hunger and thirst and in nakedness and dire... Oh yeah, where are you? Because you did not serve the Lord your God joyfully and gladly in the times of prosperity. Therefore, in hunger and thirst, in nakedness and pure dire poverty, you will serve the enemies the Lord, the God, will send against you. He will put an iron yoke on your neck until he has destroyed you. The Lord will bring a nation against you from far away, from the ends of the earth, like an eagle swooping down, a nation whose language you will not understand. Well, we have a migration a problem right now in Europe. Well, guess who those people whose nation, whose language you don't speak come from? Guess what's happening right now? Fierce looking nation without respect for the old or pity for the young. Well, that happened basically in Köln, Germany, right now. They don't care. They really don't care. These people really don't care. Are they to blame? Well, basically, what you see here from the Deuteronomy 28 is no, they are not to blame. They're just the instrument that God uses to rebuke Europe's falling off of Christianity. That's because Europe is falling off of God. So God will send an instrument. So these people are not the cause. We, the European people, are the cause. And they are just an instrument for it. Fierce looking nation without respect for the old and the pity for the young. They will devour the young of your livestock and the crops of your land until you are destroyed. They will devour the young of your livestock. Well, what I happen to know is that shawarma and so on is made from lamb's meat, young lambs, preferably. Okay. They will leave you no grain, new wine, or oil, nor any calves of your herds or lambs of your flocks until you are ruined. They will lay siege to you, all the cities throughout your land until the high fortified walls in which you trust fall down. They will besiege. I mean, if you look at Paris, London, Köln right now, and also in Den Haag, here in Holland, in Den Haag, and more of these people try to take over. And it will get worse. They will besiege all your cities throughout the land the Lord God is giving you. Because of the suffering that your enemies will inflict on you, during the siege you will eat the fruit of your womb, the flesh of your sons and daughters, the Lord your God has given you. Well, luckily it's not so far yet, so yeah, there may be time to rethink it all and repent to God. But if you stay stubborn and don't return to God, the God of the Bible, Yeshua, then this will happen one day. Of course, I'm not God to decide about this, but well, this is what God's Word says. It's not what, not what I say, it's God's Word who says it. Even the most gentle and sensitive man among you will have no compassion for his own brother or the wife he loves or his surviving children, and he will not give to one of them any of the flesh of his children that he is eating. It will be all he has left because of the suffering your enemy will inflict on you during the siege of all your cities. The most gentle and sensitive woman amongst you, so sensitive and gentle that she would not even venture to touch the ground with the sole of her foot, will be grudged the husband she loves and her own son or daughter, the afterbirth from her womb and the children she bears. For she intends to eat them secretly during the siege and in the stress that your enemy will inflict on you in your cities. If you do not carefully follow all the words of this law which are written in this book and do not revere this glorious and awesome name, the Lord your God, the Lord will send a fearful plague on you and your descendants, harsh and even and prolonged disaster and severe and lingering illnesses. He will bring upon you all diseases of Egypt that you dreaded, and they will cling to you. The Lord will also bring on you every kind of sickness and disaster not recorded in this book of the law until you are destroyed. You were as numerous as the stars in the sky, but you will be left if a few in number, because you did not obey the Lord your God. That's the reason. God wants you to obey him. He wants the recognition that he's God and wants that you obey, him. If you don't, well, that's up to you, of course, but then don't be surprised about these things coming over you. Okay. Just as it pleased the Lord to make you prosper and increase in number, in that case, so it will please him to ruin and destroy you. You will be uprooted from the land you are entering to possess. Then the Lord will scatter you amongst the nations from one end of the earth to the other. There you will worship other gods, gods of wood and stone, which neither you nor your fathers have known. Amongst those nations you will find no repose, no resting place for the sole of your foot. There the Lord will give you anxious mind, eyes weary with longing and despairing hearts. You will live in constant suspense, filled with dread both night and day, never sure of your life. In the morning you will say, if it only were evening, and in the evening, if it only were morning, because of the terror that will fill your hearts and the sight that your eyes will see. The Lord will send you back in ships to Egypt on a journey I said you should never make again. Then you will offer yourself for sale to your enemies as male and female slaves, but no one will buy you. Folks, this is not only a prophecy of 3,500 years old, it also became a reality in 70 after Christ and 135 after Christ with the Jewish people. This happened to the Jewish people about 2,000 years ago. It really happened, folks. It is history. Look at Titus' triumph arch in, what is it? In Rome, I think. Is it Rome or... yeah, I think it's in Rome. Titus' triumph arch, where you see that the items from the temple, the Herodian, the second temple, or the temple of Herodias, are taken out of the temple. So, and they were exiled. They were sold as slaves. There were so many Jewish people in those days. The Romans conquered Jerusalem, destroyed it, and destroyed Israel in those days. And they sold all the Jewish people as slaves. But there were so many slaves that they were priceless. They had no price. They were given away for free. So many Jewish slaves were back there, and they were sold on the Egypt market and spread out over all the world. That's why they come from all over the world back to Israel right now. But what goes for the Jewish people, let it be an example for us, for Europe and for America, for all the Christian nations around this world. Because what God will is doing the same thing to Europe right now, step by step. It's a process. It doesn't happen from one to the other day, luckily. So you have time to think it over and repent over it and come back to God. That's what God wants. God wants to bless you. He does not want to curse you. But it requires that you accept that God is God who he says he is. As the Bible, the Old Testament, but also the New Testament, as he says he is. If you look at the history, Europe was I repeat myself, I know, but to stress out the message, in the Middle Ages, Europe was a Christian continent, and it prospered, folks. The promises, the blessings were active in the Middle Ages because everybody, or the majority of the people, believed in the Bible, in God, the God of the Bible, and Europe prospered. Today we see the reverse process. It's not too late yet. Please repent for your own good. Please repent to God Jesus Christ, to the God of the Bible. And then you may prosper once more. Most people, of course, will not listen to this message, unfortunately. And then these curses will take on, grow and grow and grow. Okay, thanks for watching. This is the message. I hope you repent for your own good. Not for me. You don't do it for me in the first place. It's for your own good. Okay, thanks for watching. See you next time. I wish I had a better news.